Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. An interesting shaila that came up already in the brought in Shailos Teshuvos Maram Shik, Yeridea Sof Siman Kuf Ayin, and also in Shailos Teshuvos Tufnas Pernoyach, Chelik Beis Amud Shin Ayin Dalad. The shaila was that they were asked if after someone passes away and the family wants to have something at home to remember the one who deceased, the one who left them. So they asked if they're allowed to take a picture of the mess. So they should have it as a zikaron. And in their house, is it something, because we know that you're not allowed to benefit from a mess after it passes away. Is there any problem taking a picture of from a mess after it passes away? A mess is when it's already dead. Is there any chisaron? And in both of those poskim, they seem to be machmir, that there is not something that it should be done, even though we find in the Gemara's times, we find that, for example, Hurdus Arusha, the Gemara says, saw a beautiful child, a beautiful looking person, so he wanted to keep this face, he wanted to keep this person, this image, for him a long time. So the Gemara says, Tanna Sheva Shnim Bedufsha. He kept that body, the tinoikis from Beis Chashminoi, he kept him wrapped in honey for 7 years and to keep it looking fresh. So we see it was a concept that people did do, obviously, goyim. But the question is it prohibited? Is it something not nice for the mess? However, obviously, the difference between the Beis Chashminoi story that Hurdus HaRasha did, he did it as a cruel person. He wanted something, a nice statue. He wanted a nice thing in his house. It's a pure Hanah for himself. Whereas the question that they were asked is, because the family wants to have a zikaron, a remembrance, always to remember their tzaddik, always to remember their father, always to remember their close relative, it's not something not nice. Maybe something good could come from that. That by having the father's and mother's image physically in front of them, it might keep them on the right derech. Is that something that could be done? So some try to say that in Taimei Menhagim, in Yoni Simachos, Ois Tav Tav Reish Tez Zayin, he brings from Svarim that the reason you cover the mess, you cover his face, is shaloi pen yizbaza be'enov. We don't want to hurt the mess, and the mess is going to feel embarrassed that people see him as he is, so he wants to be covered. Why is he going to be embarrassed? So the explanation is, as long as somebody is alive, so there is life and soul, there is movement, there's excitement, fine, people interact. But when the neshama, the ruach chaim, the spirit leaves a person, it's all it is bones, all meat and bones. Nobody wants to be seen that way, and that's the reason it's brought in time and menhagim. That's the reason you cover the mess, because you don't want to cause a bizoyin for the mess. If that's true, some achrayin try to discuss if that's a reason why you shouldn't take a picture to have. Because just like you don't want to see the mess doesn't want to be seen when he doesn't have life in him. So too, a picture of that situation shouldn't be taken to have forever. So the Achrayim said like this: yes, it makes sense what you're saying, that there is, it might be some bizoyin for the mess, but at the same time, it's brought in Sefer Chassidim, in Simen Tav Nun, it's brought that we all know that when at a yard side or special times, people go to visit the resting place of somebody who deceased. You go to a caver and say something there. Say, daven or learn. If, and there's a tremendous aliyah for the neshama of the deceased when people come to the caver. If that's true, why are you so sure that it's going to be a bizarre for the mess? Not if somebody just walks by and looks at him that way, I see it. But if somebody takes a picture and the picture is in the house So it should remind people, right? Remind the family who your parent was, who your relative was, what kind of great person he was, and all that could do is perhaps arouse you to do more tshuva. Why? And rousing the tshuva due to the picture, not only it's not a bizayin for the deceased, it's actually, it might lift him up. And especially this whole concept, as I said, that we're worried about the bizui hames, is not necessarily straight from the Gemara. It came on later. In the Gemara, Masechet Moed Katan, Daf Chav Zayin Amud Aleph, it says, Barishaina, originally in the earlier years, Hayu Megalim Pnei Ashirim, the rich people who, when they passed away, they still looked good. They were uncovered. Their face was uncovered. The poor people, because they looked like Nebuch, they suffered so much, they covered the poor people's face. We didn't want to embarrass them. However, not to make differences between the rich and the poor, Hiskinu, the Chachamim, were misaking, everybody gets covered, rich or poor. From that Gemara we see that not necessarily seeing a dead body without life, dead bodies without life, is a bizoyin for the mess. V'hodaya, originally the Ashirim, were uncovered. People are allowed to see them that way. So therefore, if you know that a tremendous merit could come to the family, because when they have the picture, they will know who, they will remember from years later who their father was, who their grandfather is, and it's going to lead to trickle down. People are going to do better Torah mitzvahs. Some of the Achraim today say, then it would be allowed.